Hello students, today we are going to study the first chapter of Honeycomb class 7. The name of the chapter is Three Questions. As you can see in the picture, there's a honeybee with three questions and a crown on its head. Now you must be thinking that this chapter has three questions and its answer and that's done. The whole chapter is over. No, it's not exactly like that. This is a very interesting chapter, a very thought-provoking chapter. This story is actually told by Leo Tolstoy, and this story has been told several times in different culture with different stories and different backgrounds. Today we are going to study this chapter with a king in the setting. The story is all about a king who is having three questions in his head. Now, we all humans are having some questions in our life sometime or the other. Like I had a question, that is, what is the aim of life? This question has been haunting throughout my childhood until now. I still haven't got the perfect answer. Now it's time for us to find the answers. Maybe the answers are throughout the life we get it. They do not have a perfect answer, but we get it throughout our life. Let us study the chapter and get to know what were the three questions and did the king ever got the answers or not. Let us read the chapter. Three questions. The thought came to a certain king that he would never fail if he knew three things. These three things were: what is the right time to begin something? Which people should he listen to? What is the most important thing for him to do? So, students, what are the three questions? What is the right time to begin anything? And the second question was, which person should he listen to all the time? And the third question is, what is the most important task for him to do? The king therefore sent messengers throughout his kingdom, promising a large sum of money to anyone who would answer these three questions. Many wise men came to the king, but they all answered the questions differently. In reply to the first question, some people who came to his kingdom, they said that the king must prepare a timetable and then follow it strictly. So, students, the king had set a huge sum of money for anyone who can give the answer. So, a lot of wise men came to his court and they tried giving the answer to the three questions. So, like, to do any task at a very good time, people say that we should have a timetable. So the same suggestion was given by some wise people in his court, that if the king wants to do any task at a proper time, he must prepare a timetable and follow it strictly. Only in this way, they said, could he do everything at its proper time. Others said that it was impossible to decide in advance the right time for doing something. So, students, this argument is also correct, that it is impossible for us to decide everything in advance, so we are unable to follow the timetable strictly. The king should notice all that was going on and avoid foolish pleasure. Some people advised the king that king should notice all that was going on and he should avoid foolish pleasure and always do whatever seemed necessary at that time. Okay, I really like this suggestion of that man, that he should avoid foolish pleasures and he should do any task whichever seemed necessary at that time. But yet others said that the king needed a council of wise men who would help him act at the proper time. So some people suggested that, like, our Prime Minister Modi has a cabinet of ministers who always gives advice time to time. So some suggested that the king should have a council of ministers or council of wise men, known as counselors, who would always give him good advice and who would provide all the help at the proper time. This was because one man would find it impossible to decide correctly without help from others, the right time for every action. So the man suggested that a single man cannot take the best result or the best action at the proper time, so he should be advised by a group of wise men. But then others also said that there were some things which could be urgent. Very right, that there can be many things which is urgent. These things could not wait for the decision of the council. In order to decide the right time for doing something, it is necessary to look into the future. Oh, come on, this is too much. I didn't expect that they will be telling these things also. So what the people were saying that this there can be many things which can be urgent. So to know what is going to happen further, we have to look into future so that we can decide what is the best action to do it. So, in order to decide the right time for doing something, it is necessary to look into the future, and only magicians can do that. So, the king therefore would have to go to magicians. So, what a blatant suggestion given by some wise men that the king should go to magician and tell the magician to look into the future, that what actions I have to do in future, and I have to plan accordingly. I didn't like this suggestion. Let's move forward. In their answers to the second question, some said the people most necessary to the king were his counselors. Yes, this is right. Some people suggested that the second question was that the king should listen whom. So some people suggested that the king should listen to his counselor, the group of wise men. Others said that the king should listen to priests, the pundits. A few others chose the doctors, and yet others said that his soldiers were the most necessary. All of them were having valid points, but I don't think so the answer was satisfactory to the king. Then, to the third question, some said that the king. What was the third question? Can you remember? Yes, the third question was what is the most important task for him to do in his life? So, to the third question, some said that the king should work on science. Some said that he should choose fighting, and yet others chose religious worship. As the answer to his questions were so different, the king was not satisfied and gave no reward. It is agreeable that so many people were giving different opinions and none of the answers were satisfactory to the king's level. So the king didn't give any reward to anyone. Instead, he decided to seek the advice of a certain hermit who was widely known for his wisdom. So the king really wanted, he was die hard, he really wanted the answers. So he thought that let him only seek the answer, let him explore the answers. So one day, what happened? The king decided to seek an advice of the certain hermit in that kingdom. In a village, there was a hermit. Hermit means sadhus, sages, saints, who are very wise people who live in isolation, who live in jungles. They do not meet people often, but they have a lot of wisdom in them. So the king also decided to meet certain hermit who was widely known for his wisdom. The hermit lived in a wood which he never left. He saw no one but simple people, and so the king put on ordinary clothes. Before he reached the hermit's hut, the king left his horse with his bodyguard and went alone. So where was the hermit living? Yes, the hermit was living in a wood. Wood does not means wood, it means jungle, and he never left that place. The hermit didn't meet anyone. He only met people of simple attire, people of simple thinking, people of lower class, not the high class officials. So the king didn't go in king clothes, rather he went in ordinary clothes so that the sage wouldn't understand or wouldn't recognize him. Before he reached the hermit's hut, the king left his horse with his bodyguard and went alone. So why did the king leave his bodyguard away from the hermit's house? Just because if he would go with his bodyguard, the hermit would have understood that he is a king and he is a man with high power and high authority, so he wouldn't meet him. So basically, he left his bodyguard and he went walking to the hermit's home. As the king came near the hermit's hut, he saw the hermit digging the ground in front of his hut. He greeted the king and continued digging. So as soon as the king reached the hermit's place, what was the scenario? The hermit was digging the ground near the hut, and he greeted the king and he continued digging. You know, these hermits, they are having a lot of respect, a lot of prestige. They don't talk so casually, or they are not frank to everyone. The hermit was old and weak, and as he worked, he breathed heavily. The king went up to the hermit and said, "I have come to you, wise hermit, to ask you to answer three questions. How can I learn to do the right thing at the right time? Who are the people I need most? And what affairs are the most important?" The hermit listened to the king but did not speak. He went on digging. "You are tired," said the king. "Let me take the spade and work in your place." So the hermit said, "Thanks." Giving the king his spade, he sat down. So what is the scenario here? You can see in the picture that the king came with his request that, "Oh wise hermit, I have come to you to ask three questions, answer." And he reiterated the three questions, and then the hermit listened but he did not say a single word. So the king, as generosity or a generous action, he said that, "You are tired, give me the spade, I'll work for you." So the hermit gave, and the king continued digging the ground. So it's the story is getting more interested. Let's see what happens further. Till then, study this much. We will see you in the next video. Goodbye.